Hello all, my name is Zohir Chaudhary. Today we'll talk about carbon dioxide and global temperature rise. This record in here is known as the Keeling curve and is the longest records of carbon dioxide concentration in the air. It is recorded in Mauna Loa, Hawaii, and it was done by a scientist from Scripps Institute of Oceanography in San Diego, and his name is Keeling. He started measuring carbon dioxide concentration in Mauna Loa, Hawaii in 1958, and since that measurement started, he kept on measuring over and over and over again. And over time, he started seeing a pattern of carbon dioxide concentration slowly rising over the years. And right now, as we can see, concentration of carbon dioxide from 316 or so in the from 1958 has risen past 400 and has reached about 410, close to 410 as of May 2000 of last year. So almost 100 ppm increase in a span of slightly more than 60 some years or so. And as we zoom in the last few years in here, from 2013 to 2017 or so, you can see that every year it is rising by a few ppm. So this part of this carbon dioxide concentration time series graph is showing the Mauna Loa, Hawaii data that we just introduced from 1958 all the way more or less to present. In this graph, it kind of stops in here, but we know that right now concentration has gone all the way up to 410, which would be somewhere in here if it were to extrapolate it. So this is the direct measurement of carbon dioxide in the air, essentially measuring directly in a location. So this data has been showing the concentration has been rising, but we have no idea how the concentration was before 1958. In order to reconstruct carbon dioxide concentration in the air before 1958, we needed to find alternative ways of measuring carbon dioxide because there were no direct measurements before that. So ice core data was something that came up. Why ice core data? Is because ice core preserves the ice from back in time in layers and layers and layers. So as ice drops in from the past, it gets compacted and a new layer falls on top and a new layer falls on top every year, and that it keeps on getting compacted. So each layer leads to one record from the past, 1 year of record from the past. So as we drill deep into the ice core, for example, in Antarctica or in Greenland or even in glaciers, you can actually go back from the present to the past and beyond 1958 all the way into the past. And in here you can see almost 150 years of additional data that shows that concentration of carbon dioxide in the air was much lower than right now. So how did you know that? Because in each layer of the ice core, there are compacted layer. There are ice bubbles that are air bubbles that are stuck. Those air bubbles get stuck because snow is full of air, and as it becomes compacted, the snow releases the air, but some of that air gets actually trapped into the ice layer, and that bubble of air, it's actually air from the past, from that specific time when that layer was formed. So by analyzing all these air bubbles from the past, we can, for specific gases properties, we can reconstruct the property of that gases in the air at that time. In this case, we are able to reconstruct carbon dioxide concentration. Here I'm showing the National Ice Core Lab in Denver, Colorado, where they're storing all of this extracted ice core from various places around the globe. Here you can see that the Mauna Loa Hawaii data, that is the last 50 or 60 years of data, then the various ice core data in various parts of the globe in here going all the way up to almost 1,000 years or more. And in color you can see the various places where the source of the ice is from. And you can see that this sharp rise of CO2 was actually coming right around 1800, and before then, more or less carbon dioxide was relatively flat. And this is actually where the Industrial Revolution started. Carbon dioxide concentration started increasing in the air because of fossil fuel combustion, which led to an increase of carbon dioxide as we see in here. However, not only carbon dioxide has been increasing since the Industrial Revolution, we are seeing methane as well has been increasing, and so has nitrous oxide. All three of them are greenhouse gases. The source of carbon dioxide, if you remember, it's beside natural sources, are deforestation, fossil fuel burning, as well as other types of carbon dioxide sources that are more anthropogenic in nature. Methane comes from paddy field, more paddy, like more rice cultivation, as well as more landfill, expansion, because all of that degradation leads to, decomposition leads to more methane in the air. And finally, nitrous oxide, it's actually coming from fertilizer usage. So we can see that all of this have a strong anthropogenic signal, and this is the natural and this is the recent anthropogenic signal that is has led to these recent peaks. So as greenhouse gas concentration has been rising in the air, we should see a corresponding rise in temperature, and of course we've been seeing it. So temperature, direct temperature measurement in the Earth has shown some ups and downs in the past, but right now it's constantly rising and rising and rising almost every year. In fact, the warming trend has been continuing, with the 2016 being the hottest on temperature record, and in the last 50 years, as you can see, this last 50 years is the warmest half century over 6,000 years of ice core data. And as you can see in here, the last full decade of measurement, it has been definitely the hottest on Earth. We can see this trend, that this trend line has been becoming sharper and sharper and sharper, so it's steadily rising. Which part of the globe is experiencing more warming? Pretty much all over the Earth we're seeing more warming, but definitely this northern hemisphere, especially in the colder area, Alaska, Canada, Greenland, Siberia, and parts of northern Europe, Scandinavian country, this is where most of the warming has been seeing. And in fact, we can see a 4 degree Fahrenheit warming in this region, whereas in other regions, it's about 1 to 1.5 degree Fahrenheit warming. But the trend is almost everywhere. Okay, so let's do a quick concept check. The last full decade is the warmest decade on record. True or false? That's true. Exactly. Another concept check, true and false. Well, actually, this is an option, an option test. So based on direct measurement and I-score records, which of the following gas or gases have been rising in concentration in the atmosphere? Carbon dioxide, methane, oxygen, nitrogen, or any two of the above? That's correct. So carbon dioxide concentration has been rising, as well as methane concentration has been rising. So the answer is E, both A and B. All right. Thank you for listening. Bye.